to start, you're going to need some paper, and you can use whatever type of paper you want depending on what you're using it for, but here I'm just using regular copy paper. The next is to visualize what size you want your sketchbook or notebook to be. Here I'm just folding it in quarters because I want something that I can carry around pretty easily. And the next step is to think about where you want your hole punches to be. You can either punch it on the short side of the paper or the long side of the paper. It really doesn't matter. So you're going to need a hole puncher, and here's mine. It's kind of old, but it still works. So for here, I'm just using two hole punches, and it really doesn't matter how many hole punches you have, as long as it's more than one. I think it'll work. So here I'm just going to cut my individual pages with a straight edge and an X-Acto knife. Try not to use scissors if possible because the cuts won't be as consistent. And if you have a paper cutter, I think that would work best. So you just repeat this step until you've achieved your desired notebook thickness. Now the fun part. For your cover, you can use whatever type of material you want. You can recycle old cardboard boxes, old folders that you don't need anymore, or any other scrap boards that you might have. You can also decorate it however you want, maybe with stickers or a collage, but for this one, I'm just going to use the old illustration board and keep it plain and simple. So next, trace out your page to your cover, and here I'm just marking it up and using a triangle to connect the lines together to make sure that they're parallel. Then taking an X-Acto knife and a straight edge, just cut out the cover that you've traced. Then you'll be punching a hole on your cover just like you did with the pages, so it's the exact same process. So now you'll take all of your pages and your covers, and you're ready to put them all together. So here you'll need a pair of scissors and some floral wire. Binder rings work too, but I prefer these ones better. So what you're going to do is you're just going to collate all of your pieces together and make sure that all the holes are positioned correctly before you bind it together. And taking your wire, eyeball the length of your notebook ring. Make sure to not cut too short and leave some for wiggle room so that your notebook can open easily. And then you just cut the same length for the other ring and you just thread it through the holes. And to secure, just bend your wire and make sure that you have enough space for when you turn the pages. Just repeat the same thing for the other hole. Open your book to make sure that it all works and just adjust accordingly. And here are some final products that I've made ahead of time. For this one, it's the exact same size, just different cover materials. This one is cardboard and an old manila envelope. And this one is a sketchbook that I made with an old folder and some drawing paper. I added a little pocket on this one made from some scraps of an old manila envelope. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed this, and thanks for watching.